Hello and welcome to the again module 4 of the CAMS. Okay, so on Saturday we looked into the two problems, numerical 5 and 6, where the difference was, you know, the CAM follower followed two different motions for rise as well as for fall. Okay, so we saw that during the rise it could either follow simple harmonic or UARM, and for the fall also they could use as simple harmonic motion or UARM. Okay, fine. So in today, that is for April 28th class, we have solved this problem, numerical number 7. Okay, this is a little bit different. We'll see how to solve that. Okay, so again, this is for usually asked for 20 marks. All right, so here is the question. Draw the profile of a cam operated by a knife edge follower which displaces up to 35 mm. Ascent of the follower takes place with simple harmonic motion in 0.05 second followed by a period of rest for 0.0125 second. The follower then descends with UARM during 0.125 second. The cam rotates in clockwise direction at a constant speed of 240 rpm. The least radius of the cam is 50 mm. Also determine the maximum velocity and acceleration during ascent and descent. Okay, so first, before we actually plug into, let us first understand or let us identify what kind of a follower it is. Okay, so because it says that it's cam operated by a knife edge follower, okay, so we know that it's a knife edge follower. Now, is it inline or offset? Okay, because since nothing is mentioned about the offset, then it is an inline follower. Okay, next. What is the stroke? Okay, how much is the stroke for this particular follower? Okay, or the displacement. So it is given here, the follower which displaces up to 35 mm. Okay, so from here we can identify that 35 mm is the stroke. Okay, and great. Next, let us identify what is the angle of lift, okay, or angle of rise. All right, here it is given ascent of the follower. Ascent means nothing but it is moving up. Okay, so that is the angle of rise. So ascent of the follower takes place with 0.05 second. So they have not mentioned the degree, but they have mentioned that during the rotation of the cam, for 0.05 second, there is a rise. Okay, so that's what, in this case, the degrees are not given, but in case of time, it is mentioned. Okay, so all right. So ascent of the follower takes place with simple harmonic motion in 0.05 second. Okay, followed by a period of rest, okay, that is the dwell, for 0.0125 second. Okay, so dwell is also mentioned in terms of time. Then follower ascends with the UARM, that means it falls, okay, with UARM during 0.0125 second. Okay, that the cam rotates in clockwise direction at a constant speed of 240 rpm. Okay, let us, okay, we know that. All right, so from what we understood is, from the question is that it is a knife edge inline follower. Okay, and stroke is 35 mm. All right, so angle of ascent theta r is given in terms of time, 0.05 second. It is simple harmonic motion, and then angle of first dwell is given as 0.0125 second. Time again, angle of descent, that is angle of fall, is theta f, 0.125 second, all in terms of the time is given. Okay, now we also know that the speed of the cam is 240 rpm. okay, that is here, speed of the cam is 240 rpm. okay, so what does this mean? That for every 1 minute, for every 60 seconds, the cam rotates 240 revolutions, isn't it? Okay, so that's what it means. Okay, the speed of the cam, 240 rpm, means for every minute the cam takes, does 240 revolutions. Okay, so let us try to solve. Now from the time, we are supposed to get the degree. Okay, we know that 0.05 second, 0.125 second, and 0.125 second, we are supposed to get the angles. Okay, let us see how to do, go through it. Okay, so we know that from the data that the speed of the cam is 240 rpm. okay, so that is 240 by 60. Okay, so this is 240 revolution per minute. So per second, how much per second? 240 by 60, that is 4 revolutions per second. Okay, four rotations per second, the cam rotates. So that means four revolutions means how many angles it covers? It covers one rotation is 360 degree. Right now. So 360 degree into four gives me 1440 angle covered per second. Okay, so every second the cam covers so much of angle. Alright. Now, so we know that for per second it is 1440. Then for the particular time, how much it is to calculate, okay? So for angle of ascent or rise, we know that it is 0.05 second. Okay, so 1440 into 0.05, that because 1440 degree rotates every second. So for 0.05 second, how much it rotates? It rotates 72 degree. Okay. So similarly, angle of first dwell is for 0.0125 second, okay? So 1440 into this time gives me 18 degrees. It's the angle of first dwell. Then angle of descent or fall is for 0.125 second, which is nothing but 180 degree. So once I get the angles for all these three, I can then calculate the angle of second dwell. Okay? Because the total of all the four angles should be equal to 360, isn't it? So I know three angles, and I can calculate the last one, which is 90 degree. So this is one more type of problem where they'll give you the speed of the cam, and then they will give for each angle of ascent, angle of dwell, and angle of descent will be given in terms of time. Okay, time. So in such cases, this is usually given in RPM. Convert that to revolution per second, RPS. Okay, then you know that each revolution is 360 degree. So for that particular, okay, so how many revolutions in this it takes place? In this case, it is four. So total angle covered per second you can calculate. So once you know this particular case, then for the given time frame you can calculate what is the angle covered for each action, okay, whether it is rise, dwell, fall, or again second dwell. Okay. Once you calculate this, then the rest remains the follows the same. It follows the same. Okay, that is the displacement diagram and the profile of the cam. Okay, let's go to next slide. Okay, so next I'm gonna draw the displacement diagram. So now I have refined it, so I know that the stroke is 35, angle of ascent, okay, or rise or lift, okay, 72 degrees. First dwell is for 18 degrees. Then the angle of descent, or angle of fall, or angle of return, okay, all these are the same, is 180 degree, and then next one is a dwell, 2 with this 90 degree. So hence I have drawn this sketch. Okay, the first 72 degrees represents the angle of rise. And then dwell is 18 degrees, and again 180 degrees is the angle of fall. Okay. So now this is 72 degree. Okay. It follows simple harmonic motion. Isn't it? Okay. Because as per the data, it says that this dwell follows the simple harmonic motion. Whereas the angle of fall follows the UARM. Okay. The UARM. So as accordingly, I'm go there. So angle of rise follows a simple harmonic motion, hence I'm gonna get the 1-2-3-4-5- by drawing a semicircle and divide into 6 equal parts. Okay. When you come to the angle of fall, because it's a UARM, I'm gonna locate the central line, that is number line 3, and divide that line into 6 equal parts. Okay. So 35 divided by 6, okay, will be something like 5.8 or 5.6, something like that. Okay. So as I told you, you don't have to be accurate, you just have to be precise when you divide this line into, six equal parts. Okay. You just have to be very, very precise, not very accurate. Alright. So once you got that, you know that from the top, you're supposed to add the lines. Okay. And get the 6-5-4-3-2-1-0. Okay, this we know. We have been doing this. Okay. Once you get that, complete your displacement diagram. Okay, included displacement diagram. Alright. Once the displacement diagram is done, next I am going to go for the, to draw the profile of the cam. Okay, so it's a knife edge follower and it's an inline follower. So first I'll draw the base circle, which radius is equal to 50 because the least radius of the cam is 50 mm. So base circle I'll draw first. And then I will identify center O and right at the top. Okay, I'll draw a vertical line and I'll draw a knife edge follower. Okay, because it's an inline follower. And then I'll get the first angle of lift, 72 degrees. then 12 18 degrees, and the next angle of fall, which is 180 degree, and then again a 12 of 90 degree. Okay, as shown in the sketch. The next things are all the same. Divide the angle of 72, the angle of rise 72 degree, 6 equal parts, and on the base circle and draw the extended lines. Similarly, on the angle of fall also, divide 180 degree into 6 equal parts, which is 30 degrees each. Okay, and get the extended lines. Okay, and then the next case again, you know, from the transfer the displacement from the distances from the displacement diagram onto these extended lines. Okay, to get 1-2-3-4-5-6- in the angle of rise portion, as well as 6-5-4-3-2-1-0 in the angle of fall. Okay, and then you draw the. Okay, so once you get that, then you know that join all the 6-5- join the, so the smooth arc, and complete the draw all the dark lines and get the CAM profile. Okay, see how simple it is. Okay, all right. So all you have to do is just practice little bit, and once you practice, you should be able to finish the whole problem within 20 minutes. Okay, that is your goal. This is for 20 marks. All right, and you should practice it so much that I'm repeating again. You should finish this problem within 20 minutes. Can you do it? Yes, you can do it. How can you do it? By only practicing, by at least solving 5 to 6 problems. Right, as soon as you read the problem, you should know, okay, this is what I'm to do, and this is how I have to get the answers. The reason you have to solve this is 20 minutes, because you have to answer 5 questions in 3 hours. You're supposed to answer 5 full questions. Okay, if you spend, oh my god, I know this CAM problem, I'm going to do it very neatly and I'm going to take all the time in the world. So if you use around 45 minutes to 1 hour to draw this one particular problem, then the time is not sufficient to solve the others. Okay, so I'm going to again reiterate, so please practice this and, you know, score as much as possible. Okay, alright, so once you did this, next you're supposed to find the maximum velocity and maximum acceleration. Okay, so again here, speed of the CAM is given as 240 rpm, stroke is 35 mm, which is 0.05 meter, and angular velocity, you know now, it is 2 pi n by 60. Okay, so 2 pi into 240 by 60 gives you 25.13 radian per second. Okay, here the lift is a simple harmonic motion and the fall is UARM. So accordingly, you know, you have to go to the chart or remember these equations. Okay, so angle of rise, which is a simple harmonic motion, the angle is 72 degrees. I have to convert that into radian. So 72 into pi by 180 gives me 1.25 radians. Maximum velocity, the formula is pi omega s by 2 theta. Substitute pi into omega is 25.13 into 0.035 is the stroke, divided by 2 into the theta, which is 1.25, gives me 1.1 meter per second. The maximum acceleration, again, a is equal to pi square omega square s by 2 theta square. You put the values and get the answer. It should be 69.8 meter per second square. Okay, then angle of fall or angle of ascent, angle of descent. Okay, it is UARM. Here the theta f is 180 degree, so it is 3.14 radian. Okay, radian, not radian per second. There's a typo there. It is radians. Okay, then maximum velocity, it is 2 omega s by theta. Substitute that and get the answer. Okay, which is 0.56 meter per second. Or you can please calculate those answers. Okay, this I did the calculation. Hopefully it is right. Okay, but you please do the calculation one more time and see the answers are right or not. Okay, also check those formulas. For the chart is already given to you. Please check the formulas if they're right or not. Okay, then maximum acceleration. All right. Okay, so this is what we studied today on the Saturday. Then maybe in the next class we'll start with the next module, which is gate lines. Okay, anyway, please go through the book one more time, solve as much as possible. Any doubts, please ask. All right, so okay, all the best. I'll see you again soon.